Do you know what satellites, robots, cars, and skateboards have in common? They all need a reliable configuration management process to maintain the consistency of your product's performance throughout its life cycle, with a constantly increasing speed of iterations in today's development cycles. You need a good configuration management tool to freeze, review, and trace your product's design to maximize customer satisfaction. SAP Enterprise Product Development is the answer. With configuration management, you can create fixed snapshots to document your product at a specific point in time and share them with your associates. With SAP Enterprise Product Development, you can ensure a consistent change management process of your product throughout its life cycle. Improve your development and production process. Document the composition of a product structure.
Hello, my name is Cody, and I am the configuration manager at a company. Based on the example of a skateboard, let me show you the configuration management process. First, I create a configuration plan and structure it with lifecycle phases. Then create a baseline that represents the composition of our product at a certain point in time. For the baseline to work, I pull master data objects from the SAP source system. Then I process and review the baseline and finally release it to lock the master data object versions. I open the Manage Configuration Plans app and create a configuration plan. I enter the name of the configuration plan, a keyword with which I can search for your configuration plan later, and a description. I enter a long text for further explanation of my configuration plan. Now I change the status to in work. Now I create life cycle phases as stages in the life of my product. Of course, you can choose any description that is common in your company. I use the comments function to support the communication with my team. With the lifecycle phase now in place, I need to create a baseline which includes the detailed explosion parameters to identify a bomb from the source system. I choose the source system from which the application draws all the information I need. Enter the controlled object, which in this case is the material number of the skateboard. And finally, I enter text to describe the baseline. Again, I can enter a long text to provide more information to my baseline. Now you can see that the structure of my baseline is still empty. I now need to upload all relevant data from my source system, from SAP S/4HANA or ERP. For that, I click on the function Pull Master Data Objects. In this menu, I fill in all required fields, like the product ID, the information on the bill of materials used, and the date from which this data is valid. Now the structure of my baseline is filled with all the structure items that my skateboard is made of. Let's click on the truck to see more. I can see all the structure items in one page, showing the master data objects in their state at date of explosion. I open the document info records to look at individual documents like technical drawings, CAD files, photos, and more. With the baseline now set up, I change its status to in work and continue working on it. Now, as soon as the baseline goes into review by a stakeholder, I set the status to in review. This means that the baseline is now blocked from any further changes until it might be sent back for rework. However, if the review is okay, I or the reviewer sets the status to released. This means the baseline with all its master data is now locked and can no longer be processed. Now the development of the product continues. It is now time to create a new baseline. I could do this as I showed before from the open configuration plan. However, there was another method that I am going to show you now. For that, I open the Manage Baselines app. Here you see the baseline I have just created. I create a new one and again enter the source system, the controlled object, and the ID of the configuration plan I had just created before. I also assign the ID of the lifecycle phase that is part of my configuration plan. Here as well, I need to pull the master data objects from the source system. And again, I have the complete product structure. This time, however, as a new snapshot that allows me to document my product as it has developed since the last baseline.
With SAP Enterprise Product Development, you can ensure a consistent change management process of your product throughout its life cycle, improve your development and production process, document the composition of a product structure,